Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick, your absolute favorite brother from another mother. Hope you're doing all right. It's kind of late here. I wasn't planning on doing a video, but I wanted to put this out because I know there's some brothers and sisters here. Help me with this. The Lord just been dropping all these bombs of awesome stuff on me. Out of the blue, brothers and sisters, out of the blue. It's really so awesome. So many things, but I just wanted to do one right now. The Lord just, He just showed me something I never thought about. If you guys who follow me, you know what I'm talking about. You know, I used to be in the Masons before when I was a backslider. And then when I came back to the Lord and answered the call to do the ministry, of course, I renounced it, repented of Masonry. I was never really active. I just joined it because my dad was in it, and I wanted to check it out, what it was all about. But I was never active in it anyway, but when I came back to the Lord just spoke to me, and I didn't know why at the time. That was in 2000, that Masonry was evil. And, and the Lord led me to throw away my things that I had, the things I'd gotten from Masonry. And I didn't know why at the time, and I didn't get into it because I was busy, reading the Bible. And I didn't really know the Bible that much before, and studying and preparing to preach and all that. I was focused on that. I just threw the stuff away, repented of it, and threw it away and moved on. And then in the last, since 2009 or 2010, the Lord was showing me that, he told me at the time, though, that it was important that he would use the fact that I used to be in the Masons and all that, and it had a lot to do with the end times and all this, and so, way back then in 2000, but I didn't start really knowing that much about or looking at exactly what the point was until about 2010. Anyway, and I haven't talked about it in a long time or looked at it in a long time. But just out of the blue, tonight, the Lord was dropping something on me. And in the Matthew 21, verse 42, Jesus was talking about how that Israel had rejected the Messiah and would reject the Messiah. Let me read it to you. It says, Jesus saith unto them, did ye never read in the scripture, the stone which the builders rejected, the same has become the head of the corner? And this is the Lord's doing, and it's marvelous in our eyes. Now, this is back from Psalm 118 that the Lord is quoting from. Therefore, say I unto you, the kingdom of God shall be taken from you, he's talking about Israel, and given to a nation, bringing forth the fruits thereof. And whosoever shall fall on this stone shall be broken, but on whom this shall fall, it will grind him to powder. So I just want to say right off the bat what I was talking about in my video I made yesterday. Of course, Israel rejected the Messiah. We don't look to Israel for truth. Israel looks to the church for truth, because the truth is Jesus. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That's John 14:6. No man comes to the Father except by me. The Lord Jesus Christ said, we are called to provoke Israel to jealousy. We, the Gentile church, not Israel to provoke us to jealousy. That's our mission, is to provoke them to the truth, which is in Yeshua HaMashiach. But anyway, brothers and sisters, what the Lord showed me was this. Let me quote something to you from the Masonic Catechism that I still have memorized. When you join the Masons, you have to memorize like a catechism for each level, or you can't go to the next level. So the Catechism of Masonry says something like this. I don't have it exactly right, but it says, from the high and lofty Tower of Babel, where language was confounded and Masonry lost, to the three-tiered threshing floor of Ordinan the Jebusite, where Masonry was restored and language was restored, or something like that. So it talks, language and the Masonry was restored. Now, we know that the three, many of you might not know this if you didn't read your Bible, but the threshing floor of Ordinan the Jebusite is where the temple was built. King David bought land from Ordinan the Jebusite, but in Masonry it says it's a three-tiered threshing floor. It was a crop circle, and they had these oxen pulling around, a thing with these weights on the, or logs on there on chains, and then it would crush the wheat, and it would fall through the different layers. George Washington's got one up there at Mount Vernon. He was also a mason, but similar kind of a thing. A threshing floor like that. And it go, and the oxen go around in a circle around the pole there, and the wheat would fall through these three layers all the way down to the bottom. That's why it's a three-tiered threshing floor. But anyhow, what the masons are saying, and I mean, I didn't put all this together. The Lord just dropped this on me tonight. That's the whole point. Jesus said the stone that the builders rejected. Now, of course, Israel was the builders, you know, in that parable. But it's also talking about the New World Order and talking about the world, brothers and sisters. As masons say, that at the high and lofty Tower of Babel, where masonry was lost, you know, languages were confounded and masonry lost. So the wisdom that the original masons had, builders, you know, Jesus talked about builders. The masons are builders. Now they're trying to build a Tower of Babel. They're trying to build a new world order. So the wisdom that they had really from the Nephilim, and, you know, this wisdom they got from unlawfully from God, from Lucifer to the from the fallen angels to their children, the Nephilim, to mankind, you know, with Nimrod, they tried to build that Tower of Babel. Now, the Tower of Babel represents the building of the New World Order, the kingdom of Antichrist. So they're builders. And I want to tell you something else that you guys probably don't know about masonry. Masonry believes, you know, their roots of their mystery religion comes from the building of King Solomon's temple, but actually all the way back to the Tower of Babel. You know, and they're saying that God confounded their languages, and so their secrets of building, I mean, you know, there's all these different, their secrets of building was lost by God. God caused them to lose masonry and confounded language. So of course it's anti-God what it says right there, where languages were confounded and masonry lost. And of course, brothers and sisters, all those of you who have watched my many, many videos about this, you're talking different levels to the initiate, like in masonry. When you join the Masons, you're talking about building King Solomon's temple. You're talking about, the natural building of King Solomon's temple. Now, those Masons came from Lebanon, you know, where they got the tall cedars of Lebanon. That used to be a fraternity, too, the tall cedars of Lebanon. And they got these cedars, and they built, from Hiram, king of Tyre, and Hiram Abiff, he was the master mason over the building. He was from Lebanon. And so in masonry traces their roots to those from Lebanon who built King Solomon's temple. So the masonry, even though the modern day organization of speculative masons was not founded until, like, I think it's 1717 there in London, England, but actually, it does go all the way back, and then literally all the way back to the Tower of Babel, and before that, to the time of the Nephilim. So, as I'm saying, I'm trying to explain to those of you who have an ear, you understand these spiritual things, that when it talks about being a builder, as Jesus is talking all these different levels, to be a builder, to literally build a building, to literally be a mason who builds cathedrals, like all the cathedrals of the Middle Ages and all that, they were built by masons, real working masons. And then you have the different levels. And ultimately, they're talking about, you know, for individuals, you're talking about building yourself. You know, as Jesus said on the Christian side, he said, you know, destroy this temple and in 3 days I'll raise it up again. He was talking about, it says in the text, and of course it's also, if you read it, you can see he's talking about himself. You know, he's not talking about the earthly temple, but him. You know, Jesus is our temple. And then we, the church, are the temple. And individually, we are the temple of the God, of the Holy Spirit. If the Holy Spirit so dwelleth in you, as Paul said, we are temples of the Holy Spirit. And then we as a church are living stones. Peter tells us that we are living stones in the temple which is God. And of course, we're the body of Christ. You know, so Jesus is the temple at the highest level. And then of course, we are the living stones within that temple, his body. And then we individually are the temple. And then on the natural level, when you go to a church, you could say, oh, this is a temple or sanctuary or whatever you want to call it, a church building. But then we together at a different level. When we gather together, we are the church. See, so there's all these different levels. And so what the Lord dropped on me tonight is I'm talking the Christian side and the Illuminati side, the devil side and God's side, all these things I've been talking about. So they use, the devil and his people use the same symbols that we use in Christianity. They use King Solomon's temple. And this is what I want to try to tell you. This goes along also, talking about the New World Order, it goes along with the theme of the video I made last night. Many of you are looking for an earthly temple. It's supposed to be Christians, but you're looking for the earthly temple in Jerusalem and the Ark of the Covenant and all that. But God told Moses, as I wrote in the book, chapter 1, in the introduction, God told Moses when he was on the mountain, make the tabernacle and the Ark of the Covenant, all that. Make those things after the pattern that I showed you in heaven. In Revelation, we see that the real Ark is in heaven. The very thing is in heaven, brothers and sisters. In New Jerusalem, where God dwelleth, in the third heaven. That's the real deal. All these things are shadows that we might understand. They're just parables. The King Solomon's temple is a parable of Jesus. A manifested physical representation of a parable of who is Yeshua HaMashiach, who is the Christ, the Messiah, and what we have in Him, every part of it. The showbread, as I mentioned in the video yesterday. The menorah, Jesus is the light of the world. The showbread, Jesus is the bread of life. All of those things, the brazen altar is repentance, His sacrifice. He is the lamb slain from the foundation of the world. The brazen altar, the sacrifice, and the animals, that represents this crucifixion of the Lord Jesus Christ. Of course, the holy place is in the heart of God, in heaven, in the heart of God, through the blood. Jesus said, you know, He's the veil. His flesh was torn as the veil was torn when He died on the cross. Anyway, brothers and sisters, so this thing here I'm showing you, the Lord dropped on me tonight, though it's specifically about those builders, the masons, those who will build the New World Order, those who will build, you know, rebuild that Tower of Babel, that New World Order kingdom. And Jesus is saying in this text to Israel, but in something the Lord is, as I say, He dropped on me tonight, He's talking to the world. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. So Israel rejected when they built King Solomon's temple and they built their religion. The cornerstone of their religion appeared and they rejected it as a stone and said, no, we're not going to use this stone in our religion or in our temple. And the world has rejected the Lord Jesus Christ, even as in the dream of King Nebuchadnezzar interpreted by Daniel. In Daniel chapter 2, we see that that stone not made with hands came and crushed the kingdoms of mankind. The Antichrist kingdom, you know, the culmination of that statue of King Nebuchadnezzar, from him, you know, his kingdom being the head of gold all the way down to those 10 toes mixed of miry clay and iron, is the kingdom of the Antichrist. And all those kingdoms will be destroyed by a stone not cut out with hands. It's Yeshua is that stone. And who will crush all the temples of man, and then it will become a giant mountain that fills the whole earth. The kingdom of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Which He's already done spiritually at the cross. His kingdom is within us, as He said, but the day is coming when it will manifest in the natural world. It's like King Solomon's temple literally manifested in the real world, was literally built, and the temple will literally be rebuilt. But it's only the first level, brothers and sisters, the initiate level of understanding God, and the initiate level of understanding masonry, which is the bottom level going to the Illuminati on the devil's perversion of those truths of God, brothers and sisters. It's all interwoven, intertwined, and a reflection and a perversion, inversion. Satan's plan is an inversion and a perversion of God's plan. But it's still a mirror that you can look in and see the reflection of how you can still learn about God and glean from God when you look at that perverted reflection. It's like the opposite. Whatever the devil says, the opposite is probably true. You can look at that and see how the devil twists everything, brothers and sisters, at every level, from the natural level all the way to the highest spiritual levels, brothers and sisters. But the Lord Jesus Christ is the stone that Israel rejected and the stone that the world rejected. God bless you guys. You know I love you guys. The Lord has shown me so much. Since I got here, the Lord recommissioned Joshua's ministry I don't know if I mentioned that in a video yesterday. The Lord recommissioned it. He's given me several dreams and visions. I just added on here to those who are watching. I had a vision of a hurricane, but I don't. And I asked the Lord. I don't know what it means, but it's a great big storm. Now, is it a literal hurricane? See, now let's look at these different levels. Is it a literal hurricane, or is it something related to CERN, or is it represent the tribulation? See, when the Lord shows you something, you might, it might be all of those things. So I asked the Lord. The Lord didn't tell me which level it's on. But the Lord showed me something about Israel too. I'm not going to put in this video. Ha ha ha. I'll make you wait till next time. The Lord showed me something about the seed of Abraham being as the sand of the sea. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you. I love you all.